Look at that. Look at this guy on a string.
What's up everyone, I'm Chris. We've got Steph behind the camera and we're hungry to travel. We're back here in the Medina of Marrakesh to continue our street food tour and explore more of the tasty foods the city has to offer. Are you hungry? We're hungry, so let's get eating.
C'était Marrakech.
Ah, Team Marrakech.
Team Marrakech.
Oh, wow.
C'est on dit whiskey berber.
Ah, whiskey berber.
Yes, yes.
Love it. Ah, shukran.
Thank you.
Some tea. Looks like we have our egg mixture with potato as well here and onion. Mmm. Cheese, yeah, wait.
Cumin.
Cumin? Yeah, cumin. Harissa?
Harissa?
Yeah. Harissa. Oh, spicy. Wow. So many ingredients in this little veggie sandwich here. Cumin, paprika, the spicy harissa.
Zween,
Khalid. Shukran, bazaar. Shukran. Wow, look at this guy. He is packed.
Ah, yes,
shukran. And the tea as well. Wow.
Perfect combo.
That tea. Let's try this out. Oh wow, and an extra little piece of the egg potato omelet here as well.
Yeah.
Shukran deserve. He said this one is for Steph. Let's do it. You really taste that tomato and that harissa. Ooh, it's got a little bit of kick to it. Benin bazaar. Delicious. The potato is a nice soft consistency to go with the soft egg as well. So it's a bit of like a mushy inside, but you got the nice crunch from the green peppers and the onions in there. Everything tastes so fresh with all the veggies in here and the cheese that they put inside as well, the cow cheese, gives it a nice creamy flavor as well. This is my kind of food. That's good. With the tea? That's a good combo. Ooh, and we can't forget a piece of extra omelet that Khalid gave to us. Extra egg, always a good idea. Benin bazaar, shukran bazaar. Thank you so much, Khalid. Thank you. Au revoir. Thank you. What a great snack.
We're just standing along Souk Semerin here, which is one of the main arteries in the Medina of Marrakech. This colorful marketplace sells a little bit of everything from leathers to bags, clothes, shoes, purses, jewelry, even food, spices. So when you're exploring the Medina of Marrakech, this is definitely one of the places you want to start. We've heard about these Sfenj on a string here, which are pretty popular in Marrakesh, especially at this place. So come on, let's get one. Here. Look at this guy on a string! We've got our Sfenj on a string dipped in honey, and these are hot and greasy and sticky, so this string is super helpful. I don't know how we're gonna go about this, but I love these guys. Let's do it. Oh, so nice and crispy on the outside. So soft and airy on the inside. Look at that. Nice and hot. And the honey adds a different dimension to it from the sugar that we've had before. These are quite good. It's really nice to try. I think I prefer the sugar one. But either way, I love Sfenj, so I'm always happy with this kind. That's a good Sfenj. Look at all this honey. Behind me is Koutoubia Mosque, one of the most famous landmarks here in Marrakesh. The 77 meter tall minaret was built in the 12th century and can be seen from 25 kilometers away. This local bakery, and we're drawn in by all these delicious looking pastries he's got here. And the gentleman told us that this one is similar to mille feuilles, except it's got peanuts. And look at that, we've got layers of cake, the custard cream, something crumbly with the peanuts on top. Oh, it smells and looks so good and strong with the peanuts. Look at that. That tastes like banana. Very interesting. The custard cream is so smooth, but definitely has a banana taste to it. It's nice with the layers of cake, but the peanut on top is really strong, adds a nice crunch actually to the softness of the custard. But that is massive. And it actually has a layer of pastry on the bottom too. So it's got quite a few different layers and different kind of pastries to it. Oh, this is really good. Very different than any other pastry we've tried in Morocco so far. That is a good pastry.
Medina traffic jam over here. Nothing like Toronto.
Hello. How much?
5 euros.
5 euros?
What is it?
The cookie.
Oh, macaron. You're walking around the square.
Oh, wow. Oh. Where do you come from?
Canada.
Quebec.
Oh, look at that.
This is my mother making
them. Oh, your mother makes them. Mm-hmm. It's a macaron. Wow. Look at that. Very almondy. Mmm. Super tasty. Nice and chewy. Mm. And this gentleman is just walking around the square here selling them. Sugar on that. Benin. Benin bezef.
Oh.
Just a little bit.
Mmm.
Mmm. What a good find. I guess he found us. Mmm. We're here at ViaVia Marrakech to watch the preparation of the traditional chicken aubergine tagine as well as briouats. And this is the owner, Rashid, and the head chef here, Badar. So, Shukran, thank you so much for having us in the kitchen here and at your restaurant.
Big welcome.
And yeah, we're very excited to watch these traditional dishes be made.
Yes, thank you.
Take it away, chef. Yes. Salt and pepper.
Yes. Turmeric, curcuma, ginger.
Cumin.
Garlic.
Ooh. Parsley?
Yes.
Saffron.
Yes. We used to call it tasty treat. You find aubergine up, which they have their own taste, different than the tomato sauce, which is cooked with special herbs, so another taste, plus the chicken, plus the sauce. So it's really different levels of taste,
yes.
That's why we call it tasty trip.
Just tasty trip, okay. So you have different levels of the taste.
Of the taste, yes.
Very
that's
interesting.
The main point of this tagine.
Very cool. Look how big this tagine is. I think this is the biggest tagine we've seen so far in Morocco cooking any food. It's pretty huge.
Sauce, tomato sauce that we add to the tagine is cooked separately. That's the difference. It's not like typical tagine if you put it in things once at a time. And garlic.
Oregano.
Oh. It's a salt and sweet red pepper.
Sweet red pepper.
Yeah.
Chef Badar here will now show us how to make the briouats, which is a traditional savory pastry made with the super thin worka dough.
Onions. Garlic, yes.
Diced carrots.
Yes. Zucchini.
Zucchini.
There's coriander. Little salt, little pepper, little curry. Little sesame oil.
More soy sauce.
Wanna try?
Sure, yeah. Oh, this. So hot. So you can see the ground beef there, the zucchini, the onion, the carrot. smells so good. Mmm. Benin, has such a nice flavor. The soy sauce and the sesame oil definitely gives it a nice mixture of flavor with the Asian and the Moroccan spices too. Mmm, that is tasty. Wow, so mixing cheese with it, very, very unique. Chef Badar was telling us that this will now sit for 20 minutes to cool down in the fridge before we make our briouat with the workadou.
Now we're gonna start to do the briouat.
The briouat.
Not easy to do it, you know?
Yeah, it looks very, very hard. Oh my gosh. This looks very difficult, how to make the triangle perfect pocket of goodness.
Gonna start like that.
So over.
After like that. Like that.
Oh my gosh. Like this.
Like intense present wrapping.
Yeah. I am terrible at wrapping presents.
How did it turn out?
Okay, I'd say.
Not
as good as Chef Badar's. Now he's just giving it a little bit of an egg wash here. To close it off.
This is a special homemade harissa.
So we are here on the rooftop terrace of ViaVia Marrakech. It is beautiful up here. The sun is shining and we have our beef kefta briouats freshly made while we wait for our chicken tagine to cook. This is our appetizer. And these look so crispy, so fresh. And they made a homemade spicy harissa sauce and homemade mayonnaise as well to go with it. And of course we have some olives as well as a black olive and garlic paste to spread on our bread. I wanna try the briouat with this homemade spicy harissa sauce. Look at that, it's so red in color. Oh, so crispy and crunchy. Wow. And that homemade harissa sauce definitely has a very spicy kick to it. But the inside of the briouat is so tasty. The mix of the Asian flavors, the sesame oil and the soy sauce, really give the beef such a nice flavor, along with the cumin and all the Moroccan spices that were used as well. It's really such a nice mixture. Super unique flavors, this briouat. And let's get a taste with the homemade mayo as well. Oh, that mayo is nice. A little bit of sweetness to it, but nice and creamy. Here's a nice creamy addition to the savory briouats. Oh, these are deliciously crispy and so yummy. Oh my gosh. So the workadou that's used to make the briouat is so thin, paper thin, almost like a spring roll. Let's see. Wow, look at that. And filled to the brim with that beef vegetable mixture that we saw get made. Gotta try an ultimate briouat bite. Spicy harissa with the mayo. That's a delicious mixture. Spicy and creamy. Let's give this black olive garlic paste a taste. Oh yeah, such a nice garlicky olive flavor. That is delicious. Ooh, and actually a hint sweet as well, as I believe they include dates in this paste as well. But I really do just love these briouats. Such a nice light appetizer. this is the perfect start to our meal here at ViaVia Marrakech.
Obadar, Rashida, the briouats was Benin Bezef, so delicious.
Covered in eggplant, aubergine, and that delicious tomato sauce. Wow. This is the biggest tagine we've had in Morocco yet. It is so big. Wow. Smells incredible. Shukran. It was getting a little bit too hot sitting on the terrace, so we came down into the restaurant here at ViaVia Marrakech, and it's actually a beautiful restaurant. There's artwork displayed around the restaurant that's actually made and painted by local student artists, and just the design and the interior of the restaurant is beautiful. But here we have our chicken aubergine tagine, or as Rashid liked to call it, the tasty trip tagine. It is huge. There's a ton of eggplant here. Honestly, this tagine is massive. Definitely the biggest tagine we've ever had so far here in Morocco. So let's just dig into this. Look at this. We have the beautifully cut and deep fried pieces of eggplant. There is so much eggplant on this tagine. The lovely tomato sauce that was cooked up separately. And here is our chicken. Look at that. And just with the fork there, the chicken is just, look how tender that is. Comes right off. So tender, so let's just have this bite. Oh, wow, those flavors of the chicken. First of all, the tomato sauce. It's so nice and fresh. The chicken, white meat, is so tender, juicy, succulent, and yeah, just the spices, this lovely yellow color from the cumin and the turmeric that was used. So flavorful, that chicken. I wanna taste this lovely eggplant as well. Look at that. So piping hot, and just huge cuts of eggplant. Just so simple, the way the eggplant was cooked, but so tasty. Nice and soft on the inside there. It's such a unique tagine because, like Rashid was saying, the flavors aren't really mixed together. You got the delicious chicken that's on the bottom and the eggplant that's surrounding it, but you get such different and distinct flavors from the eggplant tasting very nice and soft to the delicious marinated chicken. The whole dish isn't tomato-y because the tomatoes were put on top, so it does have such a layered texture and flavor to the dish. So complex. The eggplant and the tomato, delicious, wow. It is so delicious. Oh, this is actually a tasty trip. Oh, a tasty trip tagine. All the different flavors, the mixtures, is just so unique and flavorful, so different. Benin Bezef, thank you so much. Oh wow, look how tender that chicken is. This chicken thigh now.
So juicy.
So juicy looking. Look at that. I love the dark meat, so. Ooh. The dark meat is even juicier and more tender than that white meat. Just melts in your mouth. That is delicious chicken. And you can really taste that cumin and the turmeric. And we have the nice Moroccan bread to soak up this delicious, delicious sauce. Look at that. All the nice juices from the chicken. That is so delicious. Let's make an ultimate tagine bite. The chicken, the eggplant, and the delicious tomato sauce. flavor bomb.
The tagine was and the briouats were amazing. Benin bezef, so delicious. ViaVia Marrakech actually organizes tours as well. So if you're ever in Marrakech, definitely give them a visit. Pay them a visit if you ever want a tour of Marrakech or some delicious food here as well. And you have memories of what it used to look like before now.
Yes.
I must say it is much more beautiful now than it used to be.
Thank you.
Wow. Well, Rashid, this has been a wonderful experience. Thank you so much. Your restaurant is beautiful. You and your whole staff and your wife, Lotte, have been amazing to us. You're all beautiful as well. Thank you so much, Shugran, for a wonderful experience.
You're welcome. Thank you so much.
Thank you
too, Chris. Thank you.
Definitely pay ViaVia Marrakech a visit for some delicious, delicious food.
Finishing off our day now with something a little sweet, a very special type of milk pastilla. We are here on this beautiful terrace to finish off our day with a little something sweet. We've got an extra special milk pastilla. Look at this little guy. What makes it so special is instead of it just a milk pastilla, it's actually lemon cream with raspberries and blueberries, and it looks like cinnamon on top. It is cute and dainty, and I can't wait to eat it because I love lemon. Look at that. What a crisp to that thin worka dough. This looks so fresh and delicious. That is so good. The lemon cream just tastes like lemon curd. It is so strong with lemon flavor, and the raspberries give it a nice tart little bite. Blueberries are nice and sweet. Ooh, I had a piece of mint in there too. Gives it a nice fresh flavor. And the worka dough, so thin and delicate. Crisps, so nice in your mouth, nice and crunchy. Cinnamon on top. Oh my gosh, I'm in love right now. Definitely the best part is this lemon cream. It honestly, like I said, just is so strong with lemon flavor. Look at all this lemon cream. I really like desserts, but I especially like ones that are so nice and tart like this, not too sweet. The lemon and the raspberry, just perfect together. This is amazing. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. We hope you've enjoyed the video. This is our last one here in Morocco. The food and hospitality of this country have been unbelievable. If you enjoyed the video, give it a like, give it a thumbs up. To see more amazing Moroccan food, check out our full Moroccan food tour playlist. We're hungry to travel, and we'll see you next meal. Jouine.